When the young sign says open, who's looking me over? Looking me over. If I try enough, would you feel my missing piece? I can't understand why I misunderstand my own desire. If I carry on in what I know is wrong, the colors bleed.
Should we talk about this or not?
Shouldn't we do that? It is attached to a quadriceps tendon with vastus muscles.
But it is more greedy than the vastus muscles. Look carefully, the vastus medialis, intermedius, and the lateralis muscles are attached to the femur bone. But the rectus femoris muscle is attached to the pelvis. The vastus muscles are the one joint muscles that pass through only the knee joint. But the rectus femoris muscle is a two joint muscle that passes through the hip and knee joint. So they are distinct.
But we're calling it a quadriceps femoris muscle, combining three vastus muscles and the rectus femoris muscle.
That's right, we are calling those four muscles the quadriceps femoris muscle. This is because the attachment points leading to the quadriceps tendon are similar. And they can also extend the knee joint together. But the only muscles can directly affect the movement of the hip joint is the rectus femoris muscle. First, let's draw the correct assessment of the rectus femoris muscle. Take a picture of your pelvis and leg. Draw the pelvis, femur bone, and patella bone on the picture. The rectus femoris muscle attaches to the anterior inferior iliac spine and superior part of the acetabulum. It goes to patella through the front of the hip joint and exterior of the femur bone, and it leads to a quadriceps tendon. It attaches to the tibial tuberosity through the patella tendon. If the rectus femoris muscle is concentrically active, the knee joint can be extended. This function is the same as the vastus muscle group, which we discussed in the last episode. The rectus femoris muscle is attached to the quadriceps tendon along with the three vastus muscles. The knees can be extended if these muscles are concentrically active. So we call those four muscles which have similar attachment point and have the same function, the quadriceps femoris muscle. But the rectus femoris muscle, unlike the vastus muscles, can affect the hip joint. As we've seen in the drawing, the attachment point of the vastus muscle is the femur bone. But the rectus femoris muscle is attached to the pelvis through the hip joint. Of the quadriceps femoris muscle, only the rectus femoris muscle can move the hip joint. Only the rectus femoris muscle affects to two joints, the hip joint and the knee joint. The vastus medialis, intermedius, and lateralis muscles are the single joint muscle that affects only the knee joint. Now let's look at the second function of the rectus femoris muscle. When the pelvis is fixed and the rectus femoris muscle is concentrically active, will the leg move forward or backward? This muscle is located in front of the leg, so the leg will move forward. Our quadriceps femoris muscle can extend the knee joint, but the only muscle that can flex the hip joint in the quadriceps muscle group is the rectus femoris muscle. If your plant hip joint is flexed, will his rectus femoris muscle be shorter or longer than normal? We can only know by checking the condition of his knee joint. Now consider the third function of the rectus femoris muscle. If the knee joint is fixed and the rectus femoris muscle is concentrically active, will the pelvic bone move forward or backward? Of course, the pelvic bone will move forward. The pelvic bone will tilt forward due to concentric activation of the rectus femoris muscle. If your client's pelvis tilted forward, will his rectus femoris muscle be shorter or longer than normal? Again, the only way to know is by checking the condition of the knee joint. If your client has an extended knee joint and elevated patella bone, will his rectus femoris muscle be short or long? The three vastus muscles that only affect the knee joint may be shorter than normal, but the length of the rectus femoris muscle varies depending on the condition of the hip joint. If your client knee joint is extended and at the same time the patella bone becomes elevated, even if his pelvis is tilted forward or his hip joint is flexed, his rectus femoris muscle is super short. So doing extension exercises with your knees in the forward tilt of the pelvis and hip joint flexion position can make your rectus femoris muscle very short. A shortened rectus femoris muscle can cause anterior pelvic tilt. The knee joint can become difficult to bend. You may complain pressure pain in your knees. Shortened muscles should be relaxed and stretched to restore them to normal length. On the contrary, if your client's knee joint is flexed and he has a depressed tailbone, if his pelvis is tilted backward or his hip joint is extended, the length of the rectus femoris muscle will exceed the normal length and be very long. The pelvis, the anterior part of the hip joint, and the knee joint can become unstable. Do you want to test if your client's rectus femoris muscle is short or longer? Follow this procedure. Have your client lying in a prone position. His hip joint should not adduct or abduct, and it should be comfortable so that it does not rotate outwards or inwards. Lightly attach one hand to the front of your client's hip joint. Hold his ankle with the other hand and bend his knees lowering. If the length of the rectus femoris muscle is appropriate, his knee will flex about 135 degrees without moving his hip joint. If the length of the rectus femoris muscle is shorter than normal, during the flex his knee joint, his hip joint will flex as his pelvis tilts forward. A short rectus femoris muscle can limit your knees from bending. Also remember that it can make your pelvis tilted forward or your pelvis hip joint flex. When evaluating the length of the vastus muscles, we bend his knee into a bent position on the hip joint. This is because by bending the hip joint, we can rule out the effect of the rectus femoris muscle. The length of the rectus femoris muscle is tested in the hip joint extension posture. Can you see the difference between the vastus muscles that only affect the knee joint and the rectus femoris muscle is effect on hip and knee joint? Let's summarize body types in which the rectus femoris muscle will be shorter than normal. First, a body type with an extended posture of the knee joint and an elevated patella bone. A body type with a flexed posture of the hip joint. A body type with an anteriorly tilted posture of the pelvis bone. Do not just sit there and watch, act on it. Don't just look at it, make it yours, you can do it. First, draw the rectus femoris muscle. Evaluate pelvis, hip joint, and knee joint. Try to test the length of the rectus femoris muscle. So think about it, is my rectus femoris muscle length is normal or abnormal? You can tear it up. The rectus femoris muscle. If you want to see more pictures, check on my Instagram. I hope today's video will help you to be a genius on body type. See you soon, guys! You got some kind of technique.